My name is Scott Latham. The farm here is Sauvie Island Organics. We're just north of Portland, about 10 miles, on an island located where the Willamette River meets the Columbia. And so we have lots of different soil types that we're growing in. And we're growing for the Portland market mainly. Most of our produce goes to CSA members. We have 24 acres in production right now, six of which are fallow this year, so 18 total acres. Lots of different types of cover crops are used on the farm. We have kind of a progression if we start with this time of year, being the last week of October. We're doing a cereal rye common vetch mix, and then we change over to triticale, Austrian peas, or winter wheat Austrian peas mix. In this field we have lots of sand. We're actually on an old sand deposit from a lot of the Columbia floodings, and so we want to incorporate as much organic matter into here as possible. So broccoli is a good organic accumulator. You know, all the stems and unharvested broccoli gets turned back into the soil, and then we planted the sudangrass afterwards. We plan to plant the cover crops as often as possible. Most farmers should use cover crops, I think. Speaking from experience at this farm, we've seen huge gains, the organic matter levels in the soil that we get from our soil tests stay the same. So despite our efforts to get as many vegetables produced from our small acreage as possible, we've seen that organic matter stays the same or increases on a given acre in a given period of time. More organic matter means that we can cut down on our irrigations. Cutting down on irrigations means that we could actually, for a lot of our leafy crops, head lettuce, spinach, things that tend to get foliar diseases, we have less problems with them now because we water less. The interval for putting water on the fields has been lengthened from before, 5 to 7 days to now 7 to 9 days apart in certain circumstances. In this case, with the sudangrass, following our spring broccoli crop, we put down a lot of organic nitrogen for the broccoli. And we just know that not all of that nitrogen is captured and used by the broccoli in the spring. So that's one of the reasons why we have a grass planted afterwards. So it can scoop up, use up, turn the extra nitrogen into its body, capture carbon from the atmosphere, mix the two together, and produce like a really big stand of cover crops.